Collins presents Learn Spanish for Kids with Paul Noble, the complete course, created and read by Paul Noble.
Hi, I'm Paul. Welcome to my Spanish course. The course I've made for you is very simple and very easy to use. We'll get started on it in just a second, but before we do, I'm going to ask you to just follow two very simple rules when you're using the course. The first rule is, I don't want you to worry about trying to remember what you're learning. In fact, when you're using the course, I want you to just let yourself forget. That might sound a little bit weird, but trust me on this. Everything that's in the course will come up again in different ways. And that's why you don't need to worry about trying to remember what's on it. I'll be there to remind you, every so often, about things you've forgotten. And by doing that, and relaxing and letting yourself forget, you'll find that in the end, you just know what it is I've taught you. So, that's the first kind of setup rule that I want you to follow. The second is, I don't want you to worry about making mistakes when you're using the course. You will make mistakes, probably quite a lot of them. But because of the way it's taught, you'll get corrected very quickly and you'll improve without having to worry about it at all. So, when you're using the course, please feel free to make as many mistakes as you need to. Just follow the instructions and the guidance I give you, and your Spanish will get better and better as you work your way through it. Finally, I just want to add one more thing. The course has been very carefully planned, and when I say that, I mean that everything taught in it comes in a particular order, and everything taught in it will come up again and again. Because of this, it's important you don't skip ahead. You can go back and go over things again if you feel you need to work through it more than once. But don't skip tracks. Don't jump forward. Instead, just work your way gently through the course, not worrying about whether you remember something or whether you've made some mistakes. Just do your best to interact with me and I'll get you speaking Spanish really quickly. Okay, let's go. I have in Spanish, I have is
he.
And if you want to say visited in Spanish, you'll take the English word visit and then add ado onto the end of it. So again, if you want to say visited in Spanish, you'll take the English word visit and then add ado onto the end of it. What will that sound like if you do that?
Visitado.
Visitado.
And as I said a moment ago, I have in Spanish is
he.
He.
And so, if I have is
he.
He.
And if visited is
visitado.
Visitado.
How would you say I have visited?
He visitado.
He visitado.
The capital of Spain, Madrid, in Spanish is simply pronounced as
Madrid.
Madrid.
So how would you say, I have visited Madrid?
He visitado Madrid.
He visitado Madrid.
The city in Spanish, the city is
La ciudad.
La ciudad.
Again, the city is
La ciudad.
La ciudad.
So how would you say, I have visited the city?
He visitado la ciudad.
He visitado la ciudad.
Now, if you want to say the capital of Mexico, Mexico City, in Spanish that will literally be the city of Mexico, which is
La ciudad de México.
La ciudad de México.
So how would you say, I've visited Mexico City?
He visitado la Ciudad de México.
He visitado la Ciudad de México.
And again, how would you say I've visited Madrid?
He visitado Madrid.
He visitado Madrid.
You have in Spanish, you have is...
Has.
Has.
So again, you have in Spanish is...
Has.
Has.
So how would you say you have visited?
Has visitado.
Has visitado.
You have visited Madrid.
Has visitado Madrid.
Has visitado Madrid.
Now, if you want to ask a question in Spanish, all you need to do is to raise your voice at the end of the sentence. So if you know how to say, you've visited Madrid, you can turn it into a question just by saying, you've visited Madrid. So again, what was you have visited Madrid?
Has visitado Madrid.
Has visitado Madrid.
And now raise your voice at the end of that sentence and turn it into a question. Say, you have visited Madrid.
Has visitado Madrid.
Has visitado Madrid.
Now again, what was the city?
La ciudad.
La ciudad.
And how would you say Mexico City, the city of Mexico?
La ciudad de México.
La ciudad de México.
And how would you say you have visited Mexico City?
Has visitado la Ciudad de México.
Has visitado la Ciudad de México.
And now turn that into a question by saying, you have visited Mexico City?
Has visitado la Ciudad de México?
Has visitado la Ciudad de México?
And again, just on its own, what is you have?
Has.
Has.
And what is I have?
E.
E.
Hi, that was your very first track. And this is your very first top tip from Paul. After each track, you'll hear some music like this. When you hear it, this means that you can either take a rest, go back over the previous track if you felt like you struggled with it, or you can just go straight on to the next one. It's up to you. The main thing is just to work your way through the course at a speed that feels comfortable to you. There's no rush. Just take your time and enjoy it.
And again, what is visited?
Visitado.
Visitado.
And as I said at the beginning, the way we made this word was to take the English word visit and simply add ado onto the end of it. Let's do this again, this time with the word prepare. So take the English word prepare and add ado onto the end of it. What does that give you?
Preparado.
Preparado.
So how would you say I have prepared?
He preparado.
He preparado.
Now, one way to say a sandwich in Spanish is to simply say...
Un sandwich.
Un sandwich.
So how would you say, I've prepared a sandwich?
He preparado un sandwich.
He preparado un sandwich.
And how would you say, you've prepared a sandwich?
Has preparado un sándwich.
Has preparado un sándwich.
Turn it into a question by raising your voice at the end and say, have you prepared a sandwich?
¿Has preparado un sándwich?
¿Has preparado un sándwich?
My dad in Spanish, my dad is...
Mi papá.
Mi papá.
And for in Spanish, for is...
Para.
Para.
And so how would you say for my dad?
Para mi papá.
Para mi papá.
And again, what was I have prepared?
He preparado.
He preparado.
And I have prepared a sandwich.
He preparado un sándwich.
He preparado un sándwich.
And so how would you say, I've prepared a sandwich for my dad?
He preparado un sándwich para mi papá.
He preparado un sándwich para mi papá.
And once more, what was you have?
Has.
Has.
And how would you say, you have prepared a sandwich for my dad?
Has preparado un sándwich para mi papá.
Has preparado un sándwich para mi papá.
And now turn that into a question and say, have you prepared a sandwich for my dad?
Has preparado un sándwich para mi papá.
Has preparado un sándwich para mi papá.
Answer one more time. What is I have?
E.
And what is you have?
Us.
Us.
And what is prepared?
Preparado.
Preparado.
And what is visited?
Visitado.
Visitado.
And what is Madrid?
Madrid.
Madrid.
And what is the city?
La ciudad.
La ciudad.
And Mexico City?
La ciudad de México.
La ciudad de México.
Hi. Congratulations on finishing your second track. Here is another top tip from Paul. Just remember, when you get to the end of a track, you can either take a rest, go back over previous tracks if you feel like you're struggling, or you can go straight on to the next one. It's up to you. So, like I've said already, just relax, work your way through the course at a speed that's comfortable for you, and don't worry if you find yourself forgetting the odd thing here and there. They'll all come up again later anyway.
And just one more time. What is I have?
E.
E.
And what is you have?
Us.
Us.
And what is my dad?
Mi papá.
Mi papá.
If you want to say my dad has in Spanish is
mi papá ha.
Mi papá ha.
So the word for has in Spanish is
ha.
Ha.
My mum in Spanish, my mum is
mi mamá.
Mi mamá.
So how would you say my mum has?
Mi mamá ha.
Mi mamá ha.
How would you say my mum has prepared a sandwich?
Mi mamá ha preparado un sándwich.
Mi mamá ha preparado un sándwich.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.